The PicoScope 6 software now supports 16 protocols, including digital command control for model railway systems. DCC, or Digital Command Control, is a standard defined for manufacturers by the National Model Railroad Association, DCC Working Group. It allows the independent control of multiple locomotives and accessories on a train set. In this short video, I will demonstrate digital command control data packets being acquired and decoded in the PicoScope 6 software. Here we have a Hornby Somerset Bell train set, which is supplied with a Hornby DCC select controller. The select controller sends the combined power and data through the track to controller link wire to the rails, and thus also sends control signals for the locomotive and any accessories connected to the track. In this setup, we have a PicoScope 5000 series flexible resolution oscilloscope to which a passive probe has been connected on channel A, although any deep memory PicoScope model could be used. The probe has been set for times 10 attenuation and is connected to wires which have been connected to the outputs of the select controller. The PicoScope is connected to a laptop using the latest PicoScope 6.12 beta version, which introduces color coding for serial decoded data packets. Here we have our signal from the select controller displayed in the PicoScope graph display with a time-based setting of 5 milliseconds per division. The PicoScope 5444B being used has been set to a 12-bit resolution. As we are using times 10 attenuation, we open the channel options pop-up for channel A and select the times 10 built-in probe setting. Next, we change the voltage range to plus or minus 50 volts. We can see the ringing effect on the corners of the square waves. To reduce this effect on the display, we can use the low pass filter setting in the channel options pop-up for channel A. Tick the activate filtering tick box, and I'm going to change the cutoff frequency to 20 kHz. And as you can see, most of the ringing has disappeared. We can also set up a trigger on the display. So I'm going to set up a repeat trigger here with a simple edge. Having configured the PicoScope 6 display for our input signal, we can now proceed to set up the serial decoding. To begin, click on the Tools menu and select Serial Decoding. Click Create and select DCC from the list of available protocols. In the DCC configuration dialog, select the PicoScope data input channel, in this case channel A, and set the threshold as required. In this case, I will set a threshold of 5 volts and a hysteresis value of 0. Set a display name, so I'm going for DCC decode, and ensure that the packets will be displayed in the graph and the table. Ensure that the data values are displayed as binary in the table. Once you have done this, click OK and click OK again. So as we can see, the current signal has been decoded, but I'm going to start the capture. In the upper part of the display, we can see the input signal with the serial decoding applied. Here the coloured sections indicate the various sections of the packets. So for example, we have the preamble, address byte and various data bytes. In the lower part of the display, we can see the serial decoding table showing information for different packets, and as we selected earlier, these values are shown in binary. A link file can be used to map the values to text strings, enabling you to identify the train or trains that the packets were intended for and the instruction. Here we have a link file defined in a comma-separated value file where the locomotive name has been mapped to its address and instructions have been mapped to a description. Coming back to our PicoScope display, we click on Link, Open, and we'll open the file that I was just showing. And we can now see there has been a change in the table. In the address field, we can see that there are packets intended for the Somerset Bell train,
And in the instructions field, we can see that there are a number of packets telling the locomotive to move forwards. If we speed up the train, we should find that the step value has increased. Similarly, if we slow the train down and move it into reverse, we should find that there are instructions telling the train to move in reverse.
This video has shown the steps needed to configure the PicoScope 6 software for decoding DCC signals being sent to a decoder. With this, you'll be able to keep your model railway system development on track.